Dear friends, myself Dr. M. Srinivas Reddy, Professor of Mechanical Engineering and Principal at Aral Jalapa Institute of Technology, Doddbulapur. I am going to give a brief presentation on goal setting, that is an overview on goal setting in other words. This is an image regarding goal setting. GOAL, goal stands for Golden Opportunity to Achieve and Lead. Please note, achieve as well as lead. Achieve and lead. Dream versus goal. One may confuse the goal with dreams and wishes in general. Dreams and wishes are nothing more than desires. Desires are weak and they become strong when they are supported by the positive attributes are the following attributes: direction, dedication, determination, discipline, deadlines. Please note that desires are weak and they become strong only when they are supported by these attributes. Direction, one should have the proper direction, dedication, determination towards the achievement, discipline, deadlines. Then what is a goal? An aim or objective towards which an endeavor is directed. An aim or objective towards which an endeavor is directed. In other words, so you'll be having some focus to reach some destination. No? That is nothing but your goal. A goal is simply a target which an individual or an organization intends to reach or achieve. A goal is a dream, is attainable, is measurable, has a time frame or time limit, should be in our control, should be in writing always. Dream to reality. Goals are dreams with a deadline and an action plan. Steps to turn a dream into the reality are: have a definite, clear, written goal, have a plan to accomplish and write it down, read the first two twice a day, that is, have a definite, clear, written goal, it should not be verbal, written goal, have a plan to accomplish and write it down. So read the first two twice a day. Why goal setting is required? Would you board a train or a plane or a bus without knowing where it was going? Of course, definitely no. Then why do people go through life without having any goals? Why don't people set goals? In general, people will fear for setting the goals. The reasons are, there are many reasons why people don't set goals. First one is a pessimistic attitude, looking for the pitfalls, that is negative, rather than the possibilities. Fear of failure, thinking what if I don't make it, if I don't achieve it or if I don't reach it. Having the feel that if they don't set goals, they can't fail. It is easy, no? Okay. No targets, having the feel that if they don't set goals at all, so they can't fail. If you don't work, okay, you don't pass, okay. If you don't write exam, you will not pass. No, there is no question of pass or fail, like that it is. Fear of failure. Lack of ambition, limited thinking prevents us from progress. Fear of rejection, worrying that if I don't make it, what will other people say or think about me? Low self-esteem. A person might not be internally driven and has no inspiration. So these are all the reasons why don't people set the goals. Of course, one more attribute is ignorance of the importance of goals. You're not aware or you're not having knowledge about the importance of goals. Nobody taught them and they never learned the importance of goal setting. Types of goals. They are classified as short term, that is up to 1 year. So maybe like 1 year or one academic year or one financial year, something like we can call. Midterm, up to 3 to 4 years, like you can say. I mean like doing a course or something like. Long term, up to 5 years. Goals must be smart. If you ask most people, what is their one major objective in life? They would probably give a vague answer such as, I want to be successful. It's a vague, no clarity. How to be succeeded, be happy. So just I want to be happy, that's all. There is no proper groundwork for that, or there is no proper plan, or something like that. Be happy, make a good living, and so on. These are the general vague answers that we'll get when you ask a person what is their major objective in their life. The answers all are the wishes, I can say. All the above answers are just the wishes. They are the wishes, and none of them are clear goals. So that's why, so we can say that we should take the goals as they must be smart. What is that? Let us see. A good goal is smart, whereas a bad goal is dumb. A goal should be smart in the sense specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, time bounded. So it should be specific and measurable. You should be in a position to quantify it. It should be achievable. Okay, you can put the ladder to the wall, not to the sky, no, it should be achievable. And it should be realistic. And you have to achieve that goal, whatever you set in the time frame. It should be bounded, it should not be unbounded, in other words. Specific goals. The statement, I want to lose weight, is a wishful thinking, that's all. It is again vague. Fine? Whereas, it becomes a goal when you specify yourself as, I will lose 10 kgs weight in 90 days. So, you have specified. There is some quantification or there is some exact specification in this statement. Whereas in this statement, so it is not there. So, I mean, there is no commitment. Okay. Hence, so this is just a wish. It's a vague statement. Whereas this is a specific goal. The definite goal. Measurable goals, M, must be measurable. If you cannot measure it, you cannot accomplish. That's what I was telling about quantification. Measurement is a way of monitoring your progress. Achievable. Achievable means that your goal should be challenging, of course, but it should not be out of the reach. Realistic goal. If your goal is to lose 50 kgs in 30 days, you are being unrealistic. Is it possible practically? No. 50 kgs in 30 days. So it should be realistic. Time-bound goals. One should set a starting date and a completion date to reach your goal. So these are the attributes or characteristics of realistic goals. I mean, what I can say, good goal, smart, okay. A goal should be, or a good goal should be smart, that is specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and time-bound. Whereas coming to the bad goal, it is dumb. See how it is smart and dumb. Good is smart, bad is dumb. So the coincidence may be, but there is some meaning in that. Okay, dumb goals, dateless, unsupportive, meaningless, beyond the reach. Okay, when you have these attributes, when you have no time frame or time bound, unsupportive and meaningless, and if it is beyond the reach, they are the bad goals. How to set goals? Learning how to set goals is as important as knowing what the goal should contain. What is important to remember about setting goals is correct frame of mind. Frame, like a photo, something like photo frame. So what is important to remember about setting goals is the correct frame of mind. Then what is frame? Fantasize. F stands for fantasize. Dream your wildest dreams and make sure that your goals must match your values. Ask yourself, what do you want to be doing in 1 year, 5 years? What kind of person do I want to be? Reality, the word frame, no? The next alphabet is, the next letter is R. That is reality, stands for reality. Fantasizes can become reality depending on how hard you are willing to work for them. Aim. Define your goal or goals by striking a balance between the fantasy and reality. Set a high but realistic goal. Method. M stands for method. Be truthful to yourself by narrowing your goals to the ones you really intend to accomplish. You have to filter what is possible, what is not possible. Okay. So be truthful to yourself by narrowing or filtering your goals to the ones you really intended to accomplish. Then the final alphabet, that is E, stands for evaluation. Process the results, but don't make it the last step. It is a continuous process, what I can say. Evaluation should be ongoing or a continuous process. Okay, frame the goals. Fantasize, reality, aim, method, and evaluation. Why goals fail? The goal was not written down. These are the reasons why goals fail. The goal was unrealistic or not specific enough. The goal is not really believable or unbelievable, I can say. Keep changing or switching the goals. Every day changing the goal or every time changing the goal will not serve the purpose. In other words, at least to the failure. The person who set the goal has not told anyone else for added accountability, help and support. Of course, it may not be required to share with everyone X, Y, Z. So you have to share with the trustworthy persons or well-wishers so that you will get the help and support and you will also be having the accountability. Fine? Failing to plan is the same as planning to fail. So it is a quotable quote on goal, I can say. Failing to plan is the same as planning to fail. Think of a goal as your final destination. If you don't know what your final destination is, then there is no way to plan on how to get there. First of all, you should be knowing where is your destination. Then only you can think of going there, how to go there. No planning is as equal as or as same as that of failing. No planning is equal to failing. Set goals, make sure they are in writing and readily visible, and work towards your goal on a regular basis. It should be visible. Okay, so every day you should be in a position to see that goal, morning or evening or whenever you see. So it should be like burning desire. It should remind you, it should put the alert. So that's why it should be in writing and it should be readily visible. Coming to the conclusion, goals lead to a purpose in life. It is the starting point for the success. All of us in this world have a purpose in life, no doubt. And that purpose, of course, varies from the person to person, an orchestra would be pretty dull if everyone played the same instrument. Please reread this. An orchestra would be pretty dull if everyone played the same instrument. It should be unique. So if everybody plays with the same instrument, that will not become the effective orchestra. Same thing is applicable so in our life also. It doesn't matter where we are. What really matters is in what direction we are heading. It doesn't matter where we are. What really matters in what direction we are heading. That's what many times, okay, I strongly opine that direction is more important than speed. Direction is more important than speed. So where we are heading, that matters much. You cannot change your destination overnight, of course, but you can change your direction overnight. You cannot change your destination overnight. That's not possible. But you can change your direction overnight or immediately. Effort and courage with purpose always will lead to the success. Aim for the moon. Even if you miss, you will become one of the stars. Always think big, dream big. Aim for the moon, even if you miss to become the moon, what I mean, you will become one of the stars. Success is the progressive realization of a worthy goal. See, is one of the top quote on the goal. So success is connected to the goal. Success is the progressive realization of a worthy goal. Thank you one and all for watching this video. Take care and have a nice time.